In this video, I'll create this pricing card, or you can say this is the price table. So if you are giving any services through your website, then definitely I'll recommend you to use this kind of UI. Okay, without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone. This is Sitsar with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit the subscribe button. Let's create index.html file. So inside that, if I press exclamation sign and hit the tab button, you'll get this basic HTML code. For the title, I'm giving pricing card. Now inside the body tag, let's give the div with class name card, and also I'm giving another class card basic, and inside the div let's create the h1 heading with class name card title. For the heading I'm giving basic, and next to that let's create the another div with class name card body. So inside that div with class name card body, I'm creating another div with class name card price, and next to that div I'm creating another div with class name card features, and next to that let's create the button with class name card btn. And I'm writing buy now. Now inside that div with class name card price, let's create the paragraph tag. Inside that I'm writing dollar, and I'm creating span tag with class name card price value. So I'm giving 5, and next to that I'm creating br tag, and I'm writing per month. Okay, now inside the div with class name card features, let's create list. I want to create unordered list, so I'm writing ul, and inside that let's create the list item, and I'm writing 3GB bandwidth, and let's duplicate this code. I'm writing free domain. Once again, let's duplicate this code and let's write to database. So you could write databases. Okay, so yeah, my bad. So let's duplicate this code and let's write 2 years support. So let's save the code. And if you are in the VS Code and if you have installed the extension called Live Server, this extension, then in the index.html file, if you right click and hit that option called open with Live Server, then it will open it in your default browser. Now you can see the output. Okay, and also you can see I have already created the standard CSS file, and inside the standard CSS file for the root pseudo class, I have defined some custom color variables. So I have defined there some linear gradient color, basic busy variable. So inside that I have given the linear gradient value. For the angle I have given there 45 degree, for the first color blue color, and for the second color I have given there some dark blue color, and same thing for the standard busy variable and premium busy variable. For the first color and the second color I have given some light and dark colors. So I do hope you would love this color. Okay, or if you don't like this color, you can give your own color. So for the universal selector, in order to prevent the browser's default margin and padding, I have given there margin and padding 0, and also for the box sizing border box. Now let's link our CSS file. So just below the title tag, I'm linking my style.css file. So this is style.css file. Okay, so now let's go to the style.css file and let's style our body tag. For the body tag, let's give the height of 100 vh. For the font, I'm giving font width of lighter. For the font size, I'm giving 1 rem, and for the font family, I'm giving sans serif. Okay, now in the browser, now you can see some changes. Okay, now for the body tag, let's give display of flex. Let's give justify content to center. Now you can see content is brought horizontally center. Now in order to bring vertically center, let's give align items to center. Now you can see it is exactly at the center of your browser. Now let's start D with class name card. So for the class card, let's give width of 20 rem. For the height, I'm giving 70 vh. Okay, now let's tell the class basic card. So for the class basic card, let's give that linear gradient color. So for that, I'm writing background image. Let's copy this variable named basic busy. For the basic busy variable, I have given there some light and dark blue color. So let's paste that variable. If I save in the browser, now you can see I love this beautiful gradient color. Similarly, now for the class card, let's give color of that white color. For the border radius, I want to give 1 rem. Now you can see some rounded corners around the card. Similarly, I want to give text align to center, and also let's give display flex. For the flex direction, I want to give column, and also let's give justify content to space around. Now let's style this button. Okay, so in the index.html file I have already given the button with class name cardBTN. So now for the class cardBTN, let's give width of 70%. For the background color, let's give the white color. Similarly, I want to give the padding. So for the padding, I'm giving 1 rem. So in order to remove that border, I'm giving border none. And also let's give border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 1.5 rem. And also let's give text transform to uppercase. Now for the class card, I want to give some shadow. Okay, so for that I am writing box shadow. For the x offset I am giving 0, for the y offset I am giving 0.2 rem, for the blur value I am giving 0.5 rem, and for the color I am giving dark color, and at the end I am giving 5, so that 5 is the alpha value which controls the transparency of that color. So in the color picker you can see 50% transparent. In the browser now you can see shadow around the box. Now let's style this div with class name card body. So for the class card body, let's give height of 75%, and also let's give border. For the border width I'm giving 0.06 rem. For the border style let's give solid, and for the color I'm giving that white color. I want to remove that border around the bottom, so I am writing border bottom none. Similarly, let's give border radius. For top left and right, I am giving 8 rem, and for the bottom left and right, I am giving 0. And now let's tell this div with class name card price, card features, and also that button. So these all elements are sharing the same CSS property. So I'm writing comma. So for the class card price, card features, and card btn, I'm giving position of absolute. Card body is the parent of these elements. So for the class card body, let's give position of relative. Now for the class card price, card features, and for card btn, let's give left. For the left I'm giving 50%, and also let's give transform translate x minus 50%. Okay, now it is taken at the center. Now let's tell the div with class name card price. So for the class card price, let's give width of 7.5 rem, and also for the height I'm giving 7.5 rem. For the class card basic and for the class card price, I want to give same gradient color. Now for the class card price, for the border radius I am giving 50% so that it would take the circle shape. Now let's give the top minus 10%. Now let's style this div with class name card features. For the class card features, let's give the top 41%. We are able to use that top because for the class card features we have already given the position absolute, and also for the class card btn now we can give bottom. For the bottom I'm giving 0. So now you can see that button is taken at the bottom side. And also now let's add more CSS property for this div with class name card price. Let's give display flex. Flex direction I'm giving column. And also let's give justify content center. Now you can see these elements are taken at the center of that circle shape. Okay. And also let's give align items to center. Now let's style this span with class name card price value. So now let's paste that class. Now for the class card price value, let's give the font. For the font width I am giving 700. For the font size I am giving 2.5 rem, and for the font family I am giving sans serif. So in the browser now you can see that 5. So if you want the small or bigger size, you can adjust that value. Okay, so that font size value. For the class card price, let's give the border. For the border width, I'm giving 0.15 rem. For this style, I'm giving solid. For the color, let's give that white color. In the browser now you can see border around that circle box. Okay, for the class card features, let's give the width of 100%. And also now let's style the div with class name card features list. Okay, for the UL, let's give the list style type to none. And also let's duplicate this code. Now for the list items, now let's remove this code and let's give the margin button. For the margin button, I'm giving 1 rem. So now if you inspect the element, you can see we don't want that margin button for the last list item. So in order to prevent that, I'm giving the not pseudo class. So for the not pseudo class, I'm giving another pseudo class last of type. So now if I save, okay, now there is proper spacing. Okay, similarly now let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Let's take it down. For the list item, I want to give before pseudo element, and also let's select this code and let's paste it there. And also let's give after pseudo element. Okay, so for the before and after pseudo elements, I want to give position of absolute. Now let's duplicate this code, and for the ally, okay, let's give position to relative because it's the parent. Okay, for the before and after pseudo elements, let's give the content to empty string. So this content property is compulsory, otherwise you won't be able to create the before and after pseudo elements. Now let's select this code and let's paste it there. Now for the before pseudo element, let's give the width of 0.7 rem, and also let's give the height of 0.4 rem, and let's give border left. For the border width, I am giving 0.15 rem. For the border style, let's give the solid, and also let's give some hexa green color. Let's duplicate this code. Now instead of that border left, let's give border bottom. Okay, in the browser now you can see that green color, some kind of arrow. Okay, so now for the left, let's give 16%. Okay, now you can see. And also I want to give some top value. For the top value, let's give 40%. Now let's check this code and let's duplicate it. And also instead of that before, let's give the after pseudo element. And for the width, let's give 1.5 rem. And also for the height, let's give 1.5 rem. Let's remove this code, and also let's give, I want to give background color of like white color. Let's remove that top property. Okay, now you can see white square box. Let's give the border radius of 50% so that it makes circle. Okay, now you can see some beautiful circle. So for the before pseudo element, now you can see that arrow is hidden. So for the before pseudo element, let's give g index of 200. Now you can see it is brought at the top. Now for the before and after pseudo elements, let's give top 50%. For the transform, I want to give translate x minus 50%, and also I want to rotate, so I'm giving rotate minus 45 degree. Now you can see that tick mark. So if you want to use like icons, you can use, but I don't want to use any, you know, third party libraries, so I'm creating custom icons. Okay, but you can see that arrow is not exactly at the center. So okay, I haven't, there's some mistake. So instead of that translate x, let's give the translate y. Okay, if I save, now you can see arrow is at the center. Okay, now in the browser you can see it's looking really good. So now let's create two more cards. Okay, so in the index.html file, if I select this code and let's duplicate it two more times. Okay, instead of that basic, let's change it to standard, and also for that class, let's change it to standard. Instead of that 5, let's change it to 15. Let's change it to 20. Let's change it to 5, and also I want to give there 6 premium class. Okay, for the heading, let's change it to premium. Let's change it to 99. Okay, for the bandwidth, let's change it to 100. For the support, let's give lifetime support. Okay, and instead of that 2 database, let's give 20 database. Now let's duplicate this code and let's add the another list, and I'm writing professional email. In the browser now you can see 3 cards. Let's take it to the full screen. Now let's start this div with class name car, basic, car, standard, as well as for the car premium, let's give some CSS value. So let's duplicate this code for more two times. Now let's change it to card standard. So now if I select this basic word and if I press Ctrl D, then you can select all the basic words. Let's change it to standard. In the browser now you can see that green color. And also for the premium, let's change it to card basic to card premium. Okay, in the browser now you can see it's looking really good. But yeah, there is no proper spacing. So for that, for the class card, let's give margin left. I want to give margin left of 1.5 rem, but I don't want to give any margin for that first card. So in order to prevent that margin left for the first card, I'm giving for the class card, not pseudo class. And inside that, I'm passing another pseudo class, first child. So if I save, so margin left won't be applied for the first card. Now let's add some extra effect. So when you hover the card, let's give some effect. Okay, so for the class card, when you hover, I want to give cursor pointer, and also let's give some scale. So for that, I'm writing transform. For this scale, I'm doing 1.2. So if I save and if I go to the browser, when you hover the card, you can see it is zooming, but there is no transition. Okay, so for the class card, let's give the transition. For the transition duration, I'm giving 0.4 second. For the timing function, let's give is in out. Okay, you can see when I hover, there is some smooth transition. Yeah, you can see, but there is some problem. Okay, when you hover, you can see the borders of the cards are intersecting. In order to prevent that, when you hover the class card, let's give the z-index of 100. Let's go back to the browser, and when you hover the card, now you can see when you hover, there is no any problem. But I have noticed there that check icon that is not exactly at the center. So in order to take that exactly at the center, for the before pseudo element, for the left value, I want to give 15.5%. Okay, in the browser, now you can see it is exactly at the center. So this is really good. And also let's give some background color for that body tag. So for the background color, I want to give that linear gradient. So I have to write now background image, and I'm giving linear gradient. For the angle, I'm giving 145 degree, and for the first color, let's give this light blue color, and for the second color, let's give dark blue color. So if I save in the browser, now you can see it's looking really good. After changing that background color of that body, I think it's looking more beautiful. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.